Good evening. Namaskaram. I have great pleasure in introducing Sir, we call him VC, V. Chandrasekhar, for today's memorial lecture. V. Chandrasekhar was formerly the director of KYM, the post which Swaminathan is now holding as chief executive officer, that was called as director. He was in charge of the complete administration for quite some time. But apart, he was also a practitioner. He is a practitioner, yoga practitioner, himself a spiritual person. And he had a career in industry earlier. He's an engineer by academic qualifications. And then he came into KYM and he was a student of Desikachar, our teacher and founder. He had close connections with him, move with him, both from the point of view, because he was taking care of the administration and he had to interact with Sir in executing a lot of projects and all. Apart from that, he took lessons for him. He was also teaching here. VC Sir was teaching here. And he was occasions to particularly attend some of the special lectures. In those days, some lectures were in the morning and all. He used to attend. He had a lot of copious notes about all the technical aspects also. So it's our real pleasure to invite him and request him to talk about his interactions with Sir. I have with Mr. D.V. Sridhar, who is also formerly from KYM. I don't know, for those of you who have not been, he was like Geeta Shankar. And Geeta Shankar was assistant director and he was director of the Institute of Yoga Studies. So, Sir, this is a small group but a very, intensely devoted group. And they are all, some of them are doing therapy here. We will start with a prayer and then I will request him to talk.
Yogena chittasya padena vacham malam sharirasya cha vaidyakena yopakarotam pravaram muninam patanjalim pranjaliranatosmi abhagu purushakaram Shankha Chakra Siddharinam Sahasra Shirasam Shvetam Pranamami Patanjalim Shrimate Anantaya Nagarajaya Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Vagisha Tishwarabhyam Samprapta Chakrankana Bhashya Saram Srinu Narankendra Yatav Samarpitasvam Shri Krishna Maryam Guru Varyamide Virodhe Kartike Mase Shatatara Krutodayam Yoga Charyam Krishna Maryam Guru Aryamaham Bhaje Krishna Suri Daya Patram Jnana Vairagya Bhushanam Srimad Venkatanatharyam Vandegam Yoga Deshikam Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om Badrankarni Bhishrunu Yamadevah Bhadram Pashye Maksha Dhiryajatrah Sthirai Rangai Stushto Vagam Sastano Bhihi Vyashema devahitai yadayuhu swastina indro vṛddhashravaha Swastina Pusha Vishvavedaha Swastina Starksho Arishtanemihi Swastino Brihaspatir Dhadhatu Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.
Hello. Namaskaram to everybody. It's a great honor to be given the opportunity to talk about this colossal personality called Sir. We always refer to him as Sir. Officially we may say Desikachar, but we don't want to also mention the name, but that is how we have been trained to. It's an automatic thing which happens to us whenever we see him. See, in our tradition, there is always a question about qualification. Has this person a qualification to speak about this person and this subject? So it's called adhikaram. So in my opinion, I have to assess myself on that question, and I found that my years with Sir, he has made me such that he has automatically ensured my qualification. And I think it's a great God-given opportunity to spend more than a decade with such a personality very closely. And day in and day out, and no Saturday, no Sunday. You know, you may call any time, because I was doing some administrative work. I was fortunate enough to be given that work. At the same time, I was also given the opportunity to teach. So let me give a background how I came into this place here, a very interesting story. I'll be very brief in that. As usual, I was an executive in a manufacturing company. Now the usual gifts of manufacturing in India those days was ulcer, asthma, stress. Choose whatever you want. You know, that's a choice. So, but I had all three. So we have an annual medical checkup for all executives. You know, executive means those days a big thing. Already we are with stress and ulcer and all that, what executive you are. So we used to go to HM hospital where Pratap Reddy was the doctor. So he advised me once, seeing that I have asthma, please go to Mr. Desikachar in Krishnamacharya Yoga Mandiram and learn breathing there. So promptly I came to KYM. And that was in the year 1978. And my sir did a consultancy, and Mr. Prabhakar was my teacher. And of course, I did the classes for about 8 or 9 classes. I came regularly and all that. I was so impressed, and I also had so much benefit out of it, that something told me that when I retire, I should come back to this place and try to become a yoga teacher in this institution. Just imagine, 78. So after that, in 88 or 89, I think, 89, early 89, I was hesitant to come here because, you know, there was a long gap. So I had lost touch with the people. So I requested Mr. A.G. Mohan. So he brought me, and one evening we came and met Sir. And he said, this gentleman wants to be a yoga teacher in the Yoga Mandiram. The immediate reaction was, okay, you can start tomorrow. Sir, I got panic immediately. Tomorrow, I don't know anything, sir. No, don't worry. We are there. We will guide you. What's the problem for you? We are there. No, sir. That gave the strength immediately. He is there means that, you know. So I accepted immediately. So then I started slowly teaching. And the first student he gave me was a foreigner. And he guided me very closely. He came to the classroom, sat with me and all that. So then I knew. See, that the type of confidence that other person builds in you yourself do not know you have this potential. But he sees it and he brings it out. So that's why I say one of the greatest things of Sar was, he is able to convert ordinary human beings into extraordinary human beings. And this word extraordinary is a reference to that person himself, not to anybody else. So here, you heard one of the definitions of yoga is apraptyasya praptihi yogaha. What I could not do yesterday, I am able to do today. Now this, you read about it, but can you see some person who can really do it? And this is the place where it happens. And each one of the teachers who have been here, if you ask them, all of them have transformed themselves. But themselves in the sense they are guided by that great force. So I personally feel that one of the great things about him was that he was able to do extraordinary people out of ordinary people. And as we know, everybody has got some extraordinary things in them. Only thing we do not know what it is and how to bring it out. And he will see it and he brings it out. So that is why he built up the organization also. I made notes because this subject is too serious for me to talk extempore. I don't wish to do that. One of the first things I noticed in Sir was his extraordinary attunement to his guru. See, we read about this guru-shishya relationship in our tradition. And if you see all the slokas which are by Adi Shankara, Guru Padaka slokam or all other slokams and all that, everywhere he talks about, if you are not able to catch all the feet of your guru, what use of your being everything else? Nothing is of any use. So that quality of his was always manifest. For him, his guru was everything, including that other force, whatever you name it or whatever you call it. He didn't need anything else. So some people may say that he doesn't go to temples. He didn't need to. Because our Shastram also says, if guru accepts and God rejects, it will be okay. If God accepts and guru rejects, it's not okay. So that is something which comes out here very clearly. And he used to do that. And to the extent that, as teachers, he will tell us in review meetings, please remember when you teach, you imagine you are Krishnamacharya teaching. Then the responsibility comes on you. You may think it is something simple, but student is very new and all these things. But the responsibility of carrying that legacy is with you. So each teacher represents that legacy. And that is something immediately makes a chord with us, and we are very careful. In fact, in the initial stages, anytime I had a doubt, I used to rush to sir. And he'll come immediately into the classroom, see the student, in his usual way, within a split second, you would assess something and just make the sketch and he's off. But that quality of assessing, observing and relating it into action and putting it into this is something remarkable. So this is one of the main things about this shishya, guru-shishya relationship. The next one was his intuitive powers. See, we read about this, that one of the things Paramacharya said, actually if you develop your intuition, that develops your religious abilities or spiritual activities. The whole purpose of anything which you do is we say about chitta suddhi and intuition. Why do you want chitta suddhi? Because you want to improve the mind. Because the mind is not dependable. Like Krishnamacharya used to say, mind is a jata. It has got no properties of its own. It's an empty vessel. So, if you want to use it for something, you must clean it. But clean it periodically. When you take it for a new activity, you have to clean it for that before that activity. And if you go on a new activity, you used to explain, Sir used to say, you make a sambar in the house. Then vessel you have to clean, otherwise you can't make rasam in the same vessel. If you want to, you have to clean it. That is the mind, he says. So this is one of the things that we learned, that mind is a jata, don't depend on it. Try to improve your intuition. By all these activities, what you are doing essentially is traveling in one direction only. How to improve your intuition. And his power of intuition is phenomenal. And that's why I call him as a colossal personality. Because he will see person, observe the person, and when he does that, we read about Samyama in the Yoga Sutra, chapter 3. We see it in action here. Because once I have an example. A great photographer of India had come, visited us. And then as I happened to be the executive director, I accompanied him and sir to the sannadhi, to show him the sannadhi, and then we were walking back. Then on the way back, I asked him a question, the photographer. So sir came quietly, told me, don't disturb him, he's in samyama with the atmosphere ambience here. Because as a photographer, his samskara is whenever he sees something, he sees if there's anything worth photographing. You can't change his mind. So he's in samyama, I said. And this is the same thing I found in sir. When he does a consultancy, he's in total samyama. And one of the examples of that is also, we used to have sometimes one-to-one classes in this residence. So you have to go to the top floor, terrace. There was a hut there. Then the class is over. He'll walk all the way down, up to the gate, and then say bye-bye, and then he'll go. So once I asked him, why sir, I can go myself. No, he said, till you go, you are in my mind. Once you're gone, the next student is in my mind. I must be totally involved with that person. I mean, this type of explanation. And for his stature, just imagine. So how the mind reacts and how his mind gets mixed up, you can see that also. Even that person had to follow that rule, that get it out so that he can get into the next. So that is his powers of intuition. Such humility is something which is to be seen, to be believed. You can never imagine that such a personality was so simple in his dhoti and his white shirt, he just suddenly walk in. The moment he walks in, you'll find all the teachers are sitting and chatting, suddenly everybody stand up. You know, this reminds me of, you say, about prana. When you sleep, prana goes to rest, right? And then the example they give is, there's a kingdom, there's a court, everybody's talking, shouting, speaking and all that. Suddenly announces, Raja Varar, Raja Varar, Raja Varar. Immediately everybody stand up in attention. He says, prana does that. In the morning when you wake up, it is ready for action. So that is how, when he comes in, you used to be standing up immediately. And he will do it in such a simple way that anything he wants to convey to you, he will call personally himself, he'll guide you and tell you. Regarding secular activity, you see, he is a person by nature, he was very secular. I mean, when I joined the institution, you know, I had just then retired, and in fact, I didn't retire actually. What happened in 93, one day Mala, Srivatsan and sir called me and said, how many years are you going to work as an executive? Enough, leave that and come here. So I went overnight, resigned the job, I didn't even tell my family. I came here and became an executive director. So I used to come this is a religious place, Pattapatya Vibhuti. I used to have all these things when I come with jibba like Sridhar sir. One day he told me, you have to think about the place, it's a secular place. So I stopped waiting all this thing. Because he said he didn't want to give a message. He said the message is this place is open to any human being who has got a problem, who comes here with a problem. And as teachers used to tell us, please remember, every student who's come here, because you don't call them patient, we call them only student, is already having a problem. So be very kind to them in the initial stage and be very patient with them. Because don't add to his problem. And that, I can tell you as an example, there's a great Tamil author who came here. I can tell the name, Shivashankari. So she had some problem, she had gone to many places, finally came here. So sir did the consultancy, I was sitting and then I was supposed to be the teacher. That lady said, sir, in a poo mari handle pandrala ninga, you handle me like a rose. I've been to so many places, nobody has given me this type of treatment. And you inquired everything and very soft, very gentle, all this thing. That is the thing he said. So then that itself gave her the confidence that this is a place where it will be of help to her. So because it's a lot of mind involved, as you know, I don't know whether many of you know that Rama was in depression when he was very young. And being in such deep depression, He refused to talk to anybody, he would not eat food and all that. Similar to what happened to Gautama Buddha. So nobody knew how to handle him in the family. So his guru Vasishta comes. Then they tell, this is the problem, please you do something about it. So he goes and talks to him. And then Rama asks questions, why are human beings suffering like this? What is the cause of their suffering? Why is it? What can you do about it? All these questions, like, you know, it is affecting so badly. But then Vasishta tells, the real cause of problem is what you see is only the symptoms. The pain is a secondary. The main thing is the mind behind it. So that is the thing. So he asks, what should I do for the mind? He says, pranayama. So this is an ancient tradition which comes like that, and so that is the solution also which we see here, which that's why we pay so much predominant importance to the breathing. As I mentioned to you, is converting extraordinary ordinary people to extraordinary things. I've seen it in action because number of people who come here, as normal, like, you know, like Gita, Shankar, everybody, all of us, if you ask us now, how were you 10 years before you came and 10 years after you came? You ask anybody, and we've been here totally, they will tell you. Well, they'll give so many stories about themselves. You see, the comparison is not for the other person. We are not in competition with anybody. One of the things in yoga is there's no competition. Of course, today the commercial thing has become so competitive, but Krishnamacharya Yoga Mantra will never do that. There's one thing which ensured, that is a legacy of Krishnamacharya. And that's what Sir also carried forward. Actually, what I intend doing is, I would like to give some tidbits. Because we say that if you want to protect Dharma, none of us know how to explain Dharma, how to describe Dharma, how to understand Dharma. The simplest thing is, if you know somebody is a Dharmishtan, protect him. Like that, from his actions and what he did and all that, you can decide what type of a person he was. And that would be my tribute to him, because that brings out many things. I'll tell you, the first and foremost was, I got a phone call, being the director, a gentleman from Bombay phoned me. And he said his sister is in Hyderabad, she's horizontal, she can't sit, she can't move, she can't do anything. And this has been there for the last 3-4 months. And the doctors now say she needs an operation in the spine. And I came to know that Krishnamacharya Yoga Mantram can cure these cases. So he asked me, can you do it? So I had to tell him, sir, without seeing the person, without examining the person, we cannot tell anything. But I can tell you one piece of information. He said, what? If it is my sister, I'll directly bring her here, I said. Now you take your decision. Promptly brought that lady. She came horizontal. She was lying in the bench out till the sir was free, did the consultancy. In 1 week, that lady was able to sit up, was able to stand. And you should see the family, because the husband was doing the cooking, taking care of the house, taking care of the wife, taking care of the children, everything he was doing. He started crying, weeping. Sir, you have saved the family. Now this is, I would call it a miracle. But whereas today we find, I have a cousin of mine in Dubai. One day I got a call saying that he is having a spinal problem and he's going to get it operated. I had seen him in Dubai and given him some small simple things which is helping him. But in panic when he got operated, it has happened 3-4 years ago, till today he's not able to walk straight. So that is why the definition by Acharya, asastra sastra chikitsa, operation surgically from inside without the use of instruments, that is this yoga. Because when I said this yoga, once we wanted to prepare a pamphlet, so I put the word authentic yoga. Sir said, what do you mean authentic yoga? You're telling the others are not doing authentic yoga? No, no, we will not do all such things, Lord. You will tell other plain things, but no authentic yoga business. Today we find everybody is doing authentic yoga, that yoga, this yoga, beer yoga, power yoga, so many things are coming up. That is one thing. The other was a youngster from Dubai. He came. He was about 32 years old, sir was doing consulting, I was sitting there. And what is the problem? Suddenly you'll feel thirsty. Suddenly you'll want to go to sleep. Suddenly you want to go to the toilet. Suddenly feels hungry. None of the urges were in a routine. None of the urges. You know, in Ayurveda we call it as Vega, I think, Vegas. So sir examined him and gave a course and all that. Within a week, he was all right. So he asked, when should I come? He said, you don't have to come, keep doing this, it's enough. Now then sir told me, his Vega center has been disturbed, no medical doctor can find this. Once the Vega center is disturbed. Just like you got medulla oblongata, which is the nerve center, he said there is a Vega center. And that with that is disturbed, no medical person will find out. And that he was able to solve. That according to me was a miracle. And then another interesting case was, I had a judge who was a student. He was handling all criminal murder cases. So he was so scared because he used to say, you know, I'm handling murder cases. And if I make a mistake, that fellow will be put to, you know, death. And I can't bear that responsibility. So we gave course on that, he was satisfied and all that. And suddenly he was transferred to Bombay. So after 4 or 5 months, he came on leave to Madras. He came and met sir. He said, sir, I said, what's the problem? Because I was his teacher, I had to be with him also. So he said, sir, but 3 months ago, I had some headache problem. So since I'm a judge, sitting judge, the government had to take action. They put me through so many tests, neuro test, that test, this test, all the tests medically possible. Finally, they said, nothing is wrong with you. But I'm having a headache. So he came and sat in front of him. I was sitting there and sir said, sir, did you change your specs anytime recently? Very innocent question. Yes, just 3 months ago, I changed my spectacles. Please remove it, sir, he said. Visi, I just put it. Came, put it. Sir, you had no problem at all, sir. Your temples are pressing against the sides are pressing. You're not allowing the blood to flow into your brain. So naturally, you will have a problem. So now it's all ready, you can go. You see, it's common sense. You see, that's the observation also, immediately. Then my company chairman, coming to know that I'm involved in this and DVC is involved and all that, he wanted to meet sir. He came here, they gave him a course and all that, he went to Bombay. Then he wrote a letter to me, I'm doing everything, but one thing I can't understand, VC, what is this? My evening whiskey, I don't need it now. What he has done? He said. So, the person who's having whiskey every day, himself stopped it. Because the beauty of the decision making here is not an external decision. Like one student came, or a would-be student, he told sir, I drink, he said. He said, so what? No, I eat meat. So what? But he told so many negative things about himself. So sir said, it's not my problem. I'll give you a course. But after 2 months, don't blame me if you stopped all those things. You see, the confidence of this thing that, and another person came for cardiac, we had a program called Bethal's program. Better health through lifestyle change for all cardiac people. So we are interviewing the people. One person said, I have 40 cups of coffee in a day. So we didn't react. Because the moment you give your opinion, or you become judgmental, it becomes different. The reaction is different. So we told them, okay, that is not there. You, every time you have coffee, you write the number of cups you have, and next class you come. So after 2 weeks he came. He came, sir, I didn't realize we're having 40 cups of coffee. I've reduced to 4 cups myself, he said. Now, you see, since the decision was his and it was guided a nice way, he was amenable to it. If it's an external decision, he may have to please the teacher or somebody, he may do it for a short while, but it's not going to last. So the whole purpose is to make you independent of even the teacher. Then the SLN Institute in America wanted to do a healing seminar. So they invited sir, and they said, please, you have to do it in SLN Institute in America. Sir said, no way I can come and spend 10 days there. If you want, you do the healing seminar here in Yoga Mandram. At the time, you only attached shed and all that. Can you believe it? All the international healers came. We had a Buddhist monk, Tibetan monk. We had a Chinese healer. We had a, what's it called? It's called anthroposophic something it's called. I don't know how to pronounce it also. I believe the human themselves have created this certain problem on how you get to this thing. All these people came and did the healing karma was done here. So, and the person from SLN Institute, also it's a company behind that. SLN Institute is a place. That company publishes books, fantastic books, very rare books, and once in 10 years, I find them. For 4 years, they were after Sir to write a book on Acharya. Sir wouldn't agree. Finally he agreed. And that's the book called Health, Healing and Beyond. If you get a chance to read it, then that's the thing. Because you want to protect that. You see, a lot of people write books. He didn't want that, you know, like an ordinary yoga book, Acharya and all that. No, this is something very special. Only then when you read it, you understand the speciality about this great person. That is one of the things. Very clearly, no. After 4 years of persistence, he said, yes, finally. I had a foreign student who had a post-trauma syndrome. I didn't know what those terms were. Then later I came to know about it. And sir did the consultancy, put the clothes, and then told me, warned me, third day, she'll start crying. You don't react, be patient. Believe it, third day, exactly, she started pouring tears. He said that all the dirt is coming out now. That's how it happens. And after that, slowly she started understanding, accepting and all that. But that prediction that after 2 or 3 days, she will start crying without any reason at all. She does the simple asanas, what we are doing only. But how that has worked on her, that was something amazing for me. One day suddenly what happened, somebody was doing the consultancy, I think Vijivasu. The person who came said, I'm scientific advisor to Prime Minister of India. She got scared immediately and said, sent word to sir, I can't handle this consultancy, you please come. So sir came, Mr. Arunachalam is a scientific advisor to Vajpayee at that time. And he came in a very normal way, you know, you can't believe such a person coming like that in ordinary this thing. He did not announce anything and all that. Sir made the course and I gave him the classes and all that. He went back, he was teaching in America then. He wrote a letter to us saying, my output is quadrupled now. Already his output is so much. After doing this process of yoga that we taught, what sir had designed for him, quadrupled. Then imagine, that means in improvement and evolvement, there is no limit. You cannot say that is the end of it. If you are there, you can go there. If you are there, you can go there. You can keep on going. Till when? Till you reach that. That's all it is. The other end of it, I'll tell you, an advocate was a student of Sir for a long time. Then he was on his deathbed. His wife phoned and said, he wants classes with Sir. So Sir took me, we went to his house. You know, the like hospital-like bed was put in the house. And he was actually on the deathbed only, so no doubt about it. But after examining him, Sir told him some simple om chanting. And he had that much trust because he wanted to die peacefully. He didn't want to die with agony and all that. And after about 2 weeks, the wife phoned and said, he died peacefully. So yeah, I mean, it's remarkable, isn't it? I mean, a person asking also and Sir going and helping also. And similarly, there was another lady, Norma Shastri, 92 years old. She comes from Madhuram, says, I want to do some yoga, I want to learn. So Sadhar examined and said, at this age, I think she can't do much. So some breathing and om chanting in the lying position. But then that worked so much on her mind that it gave her what she wanted. So giving the person what it needs and what you know, as Krishnamacharya used to say, teach what the person needs. Not what you know. So you are not there to expose your knowledge or experience. You are there to help that person. That is why the student-teacher relationship is very good. And also, in selecting the teacher, Sir is remarkable. He will do the consultancy. He will see which person as teacher will vibe with that student and fix that person as teacher. It will be 100% correct. There are certain things which, Sir was very good at chanting. When he does the chanting, you could see immediately that vibration. So once he was demonstrating to this group of Australian students, and I was sitting in the front row on the floor. So suddenly he said, now when I start doing Vedic chanting, you'll see VC start straightening spine. I never realized it myself. He says, any Indian who's at least got some exposure to Veda and Vedic chanting, the moment he hears Vedic chanting, automatically spine stretches. You become straight like that. It is something which we don't know about. I don't know, have you heard about it before? I don't think. And every now and then he used to correct me. You see, this one of the things we always do is we get into samskaras, habits. Maybe good habit, bad habit, but it's a habit. So I used to use what's called as a Karandash pen. It's a Swiss pen. Because in my exuri job, I always liked that pen. So one day he told me, Visi, the pen, the same pen you're using. No, this is not good for you. You change it. I said, okay, we'll change. Then if you go for his class, you notice I was sitting in the same place. He came and said, you're sitting in the same place now. Don't sit in the same place. See, these are all small things about which we do not know. We don't notice. The human tendency is always to go to the same place. If you go to some other place, all you'll find you'll go to the same place. So then you're creating a samskara. That means your mind is getting into a straitjacket. Don't allow that. Mind must be free and you must take the decision. Mind should not take the decision. And there was a lady called Wanda Scaravelli. She's a countess in Italy. And she's written a book on the spine. In there, in the foreword, you see, Sar went and chanted there for half an hour. And she wrote a letter saying, after he left, for 3 days, that vibration is still remaining there. So it is something, because something Sar used to do. Suppose, for instance, I was not well, once very ill. And suddenly Sridhar sir phoned saying that Sar wants to come and visit you. We brought him, sat down there, chanted for 15-20 minutes, he went. Similarly, he took me to Sanadi once, Sridhar was there, asked me to sit there, he chanted. Because that was because I was involved in an accident, motor accident. See, a motorcyclist in a rainy night, he came and hit the car and his leg was broken near the hip and he was screaming. And you know, being a teacher, our compassion level is so high, we can't stand to see another person suffering. I could not stand it at all. So next morning I went and told sir, I'm not able to take this. I've stopped functioning, I said. He said, don't worry, took me to the Sanadi, chanted. The mood changed immediately. See, because that is the power of chanting. Because I remember my priest in the house, Lakshmanan Dishadhar, he was a priest in Madurai temple, the family legacy. He used to say, Vedic chanting, nadi illan thatti udum. That means, you know, the nadi, the prana flows in the nadi. And if the prana is stuck somewhere, you have a problem. So with thatti udunaka, if you have a string tight and then you tap it, it starts vibrating. He says, that's what happens to the nadis when you do Vedic chanting. So in effect, Vedic chanting heals because of that. And in some cases, it helps more than asanas and pranayama. It's something which we did not know at all. I think with sir, I want to read some quotes of Desikachar, with your permission. See, there are some quotes that sir had made, and the international people had put it out in the yoga journal long ago, the moment this tragedy happened. In memoriam, yoga journal, 10 quotes of Sri TKV Desikachar. Please listen very carefully. All his qualities come out in these 10 quotes. You don't have to see anything else. The success of yoga does not lie in the ability to perform postures, but in how it positively changes the way we live our life and our relationships. Yoga has its roots in Indian thought, but its content is universal because it is about the means by which we can make the changes we desire in our lives. The ultimate goal of yoga is to always observe things accurately and therefore never act in a way that will make us regret our actions later. Yoga is both movement toward and arrival at a point. Sadhana and Siddhi. See, beautifully put. However powerful, disturbing something may appear to be, it is our reaction to it that determines its effects. In order to influence our prana, we must be able to influence our mind. Our actions often disturb the mind, causing prana to exude from the body. Through daily practice of pranayama, we reverse the process as a change in the breathing pattern influences the mind. This word pranayama, when I hear somebody pronouncing it, pranayama and all that they say. As far as I know, pra-na-ya-ma. So there's dirgam in three places. And one of the things he used to tell is that sound that you produce itself is an exhale. Automatically, the next inhale will be better. So pranayama is not pranayama, and that's the way most people are. Patanjali. Pat Anjali. These are things which we learn from me. I used to correct us on this thing. Yoga cannot guarantee this or that particular benefit if you practice it diligently. Yoga is not a recipe for less suffering, though it can offer us help in changing our attitude so that we have less avidya and therefore greater freedom from dukkha. How beautifully put. The more we progress in the yogic path, the more we become aware of the holistic nature of our being, realizing that we are made of body, breath, mind and more. And that more is a very crucial thing. So that explains everything to everybody. Change is not a direct or even indirect consequence of yoga or any other practice. We cannot depend on it. What we can count on gaining from our yoga practice is a quieter mind. Somehow the heaviness and jumpiness vanishes. If that happens, automatically you'll take the right decision. Because I call it as, in my own way, in modern way, see, every computer has got a system software and a application software. So I used to refer to yoga as your system software. So if I can improve my system software, I can use it for anything I want. There's no block on my, it's not religious, it is not this, it is not that. You can use it what you want. So the application software is different from system software. So yoga is your system software. And each system has got the capability and potential to perform at the highest level. So it's only how to bring it out. So only such great people show us how to bring it out. How be ourselves. I don't know if many of you heard of the Johari window. The Johari window in management, we say, you take any person, I know something about myself, I do not know something about myself. The other person knows something about myself, and he does know something about myself. But there is something which I do not know about myself and he also does not know about myself. That is the potential. That is where these great people come in, to bring out that potential. So this is used in management to improve the performance of people. Whenever you are in doubt, it is best to pause. Few things are so pressing that they cannot wait for a moment of breath. This is a talk he gave at a Malladi group on how yoga heals. Because though he has given this talk, innermost of this thing, I remember a foreign gentleman who's a long time student of his wrote a book on healing. And he wanted sir to write a foreword for it. Sir flatly refused, saying, even after 30 years, I do not know exactly what heals, how it heals. So I will not write a foreword. You see the humility of the person. After 30 years of all such things, he says, I really do not know what heals, so I will not put in wording saying that this is how it happens, this is how it happens. Like we say that we can't say this asana will help this problem, that asana will help this problem, which is the wrong approach, isn't it? We are looking at the person, we are not looking at the problem of the person. We are not trying to link the two. So there, he gave this talk. Only a small extract I can read, sir. There's an enormous rejuvenative force within the human system. This natural survival instinct can be used for the well-being of the person. In yoga therapy, our aim is to activate this rejuvenative force in the person, whereby he gets cured using his own resources. In yoga, it is felt that this fundamental rejuvenation force is expressed in the human system through the breath. It is expressed in many ways, but the most important way, the key to this force, is the breath. I think this is a profoundly thing which explains many of this thing. Further and most important, we can do something about the way we breathe. Here is a tool so precious, so vital, and which can be handled by the person himself. This is another thing in yoga, a person takes charge of himself. A lot of things, but I think I'll stop with this because I have massive information about him, because this is, now you understand what type of personality. That's the way I'm paying tribute to him. I acknowledge that. All this, I've been fortunate to be close and observe. Tell you how I got him. This Krishnamacharya in the papers, after reading it, when his centenary was celebrated, I immediately rushed and attended some of the functions. And there was a function in Bharati Vidya Bhavan where Alexander Governor came. And I had a foreign visitor with me and I took him also. I think B.K. Sangha demonstrated all over half an hour, 1 hour there. Krishnamacharya stood up and talked extempo 1 hour. He closed his eyes and he spoke. Nobody expected to stand and speak. So, and Rukmini Arundel had a function where they paid respect to many of the Vedic scholars, along with the Krishnamacharya. So I was sitting where Sridhar is there, and I was sitting behind here. Not go near him, but because I did not know anybody. Because my friend Butch was sitting next to him. Butch was the person who was close to the mandram with the photograph. So that's the way I can say I only know him that way. So 78 when we came, Krishnamacharya never used to come to see. You'd be at the house only. Only Sarv used to come.
Generally, what was the approach of sir in the course that he used to recommend? Very broadly, what part would be the asanas and how much would be the pranayama and the chanting?
I think the general principle that we learned was this. When you are young, you can do a lot of asanas from pranayama, then you will not be able to sit for long in meditation. But according to the Indian tradition, the journey is, as you become older, you do less of asanas because you don't need. You need only asanas so that your pranayama has influence, so your breathing must be there. You do a lot of pranayama and you do a lot of meditation. So what is the ultimate aim of any yoga that you do? You look at that, you want to evolve. First you have a problem, you want to get to the problem. Once the problem is over, next step you ask. The next step is solved, what is the next step? So there's an evolution of the human being that he himself wants to become better and better. So if that satisfies, you don't have to do all those complicated postures. This is one of the things I have in mind, I must tell you also frankly, because with all this yoga day and all these things, you see, the same people are doing all these difficult postures are coming into the picture. But my point is, we should rope in those people, common housewives, common householders, etc., who are scared of yoga when they see all those postures. The moment you say yoga, immediately they put shirtasana. This is not that. Nada Muni says, am I not to get the benefit of all these classic postures because I don't know that? So, there is a possibility. Like, it is this. So, the majority of people of this group, I don't know any of classical postures. Ask me to do this. I was doing shirtasana when I was young. Sir asked me to stop it, I stopped it. But that is not the need at all. See, you are looking at the body, whether it's nice or not. Is that the main? If your mind is okay, you're satisfied. So it all depends on the individual and how the mind is and how where you are developed. Because depends on wherever you are, from there only you can start. You can't be forced to do something. So that logic, that is why this Vini Yoga is 100% successful, because you take the person into consideration, respect the person, and give what he is missing and what he needs at that point of time. This at that point of time is very crucial, because the person changes after 10 years. There's an interesting story. Jay Krishnamurti once told a couple who had been his long-time student, "You're not the same couple as 40 years ago, do you know?" He said, "I believe." You know what they did? They went and divorced. And they were suffering. When Krishnamurti passed away, they again married. So that's not so that's why they say, great people, when they say something, you have to be very careful, because every word what they say, everyone takes it very seriously. That's the point. This is the example of that. An example I'll give you, Krishnamacharya, I think Desikachar, I believe Krishna used to tell us, in one public lecture, Krishnamacharya asked about Kundalini. So Krishnamacharya said, he said like this, "Kundalini, I have not heard, I don't know." Finish, period over. So he used to say, the Kundalini is so powerful, if you get into it, if you don't do it correctly, or if you don't do it regularly, it will eat you. It's like a white tiger. And no human being in the present situation is capable of doing that, unless the Yama Niyamas are very strict. But to us in the class, whatever Acharya told, Sar has told everything. How strict you have to be in that, how this. 3 hours in the morning, 3 hours in the evening you may have to spend if you get into that. So what you require.
What are the views of Sir yoga research?
Huh?
Research in yoga. You gave lots of examples about therapy, yoga therapy. So what are his views on research on yoga?
So research and yoga, I can tell you, because you know it was developing at that time. Because this is a matter which is a lot of subjective things are there. And individuals are involved, because in our yoga we are not saying relating this on. For instance, I think our Antanarayana Raghu has done a research on back, what asanas and what energy and all that. Some small type of research later, when Lata Satish came in and all that, we started developing that and it started growing. So now today I think it's different. Everybody is accepting there is some result coming. So that you can see one thing, I was listening to a lecture by a Chinese healer. And he calls it Paida and Lajjan. He comes to the same principle as what we say. He says the prana jammed in the meridians, main meridians, if they are released, all your problems will be solved. So his way of treating is, we say no gain, no pain, no gain without pain. That's his principle. In Yoga Mantram, if you come here with pain, then you don't add to the pain. But that healing adds to the pain. And it says pain only increases and then it becomes all right. So the research is going, it is still the human system so complicated, so complex, because we have feeling, we have reaction. And each person may react differently to the same situation. So nobody can put it in the straight jacket. That's the problem. Am I right? Is it? His view, search view. No, search view is very simple. I'll give you an example. Professor Jayachandran is supposed to be a great expert in handling special children. He came back from abroad after a lot of training. Right? He went about different yoga places and everybody said, "We can cure, we can cure." So he was very upset. He came to Sir. Sir said very clearly, "Look here, we don't know anything about mental retardation and special autism, all these things, we don't know anything. But you say you know everything. Why not we team together? We will do the yoga portion of it. You do the other portion of it." This is a great success. So research is possible. If it is done with some balance and not, you know, you try to overdo it by claiming many things. It has to be balanced. So we are very cautious in research.
Person here, did Sir ever give any directions on administration, sir, to you? Did he ever give some tricks?
I got myself out from when I get a passage. This is because one thing very simple. Discipline. So if you can get a good set of people, and you decide what. You see, one of the things is the values of the institution that you protect them. First important thing. Because when the legacy is involved, all your. I'll give an example. We had a receptionist who was very fat. Once I was asked to remove her because she was fat. I said, I will not do it. It was a big controversy. I said, we are here only to help such people. How can you say that person should not be appointed because she's fat? You try and help her and make her lean, it's okay. But you cannot. So the value must be mentioned. So any administration also. What do you see? Everybody in the institution is working towards the same goal. And if you handle everybody as a human being, they will respond. This is a very simple one. That's what I learned because it's a common. But I don't want to think in management. It is okay.
It was not very easy. We were in the administration. I can remember, but one in those days we had budget, and with Suresh Rao on the one side, DC in the middle, and Sar on the other side, we will have budget for the month. In the beginning of the month, VC will go to Suresh Rao's home and get the check signed, and that will be exactly to be spent. We cannot have even one cup of water separately if you want to buy. Sir will enter and he will say, today, we see, we will have how many people? You will get adhirasam for everyone because Periyavar likes adhirasam. So we will have to get 60 adhirasams for which there won't be money.
The problem is always there. I just want to tell you. Because you know, somebody wanted a laptop. Why you want a laptop? You're not a traveling executive. You're only staying here. No laptop. That became a big controversy. So, it's a question of how you satisfy.
Thank you, sir, for this wonderful evening. We will end up with the chanting.
Om Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yona Prachodayat. Om Tat Savitur Savitur-varenyam, varenyam bhargah, bhargo devasya, devasya dhimahi, dhimahi ti dhimahi, dhiyo yaha, yonaha, na prachodayat, prachodayaditi, prachodayat. Om tat savitur savitur tat tat savitur savitur varenyam varenyagum savitur savitur varenyam varenyam bhargo bhargo varenyam varenyam bhargaha bhargo devasya devasya bhargo bhargo devasya devasya dhimahi dhimahi devasya devasya dhimahi dhimahi ti dhimahi dhiyo yo yo dhiyo dhiyo yaha yo no no yo yo naha na prachodayat prachodayanno na prachodayat prachodayaditi prachodayat om tat savitus savitus tat tat savitur vareñyam vareñyagum savitus tat tat savitur vareñyam savitur vareñyam vareñyagum savitus savitur vareñyam bhargo bhargo vareñyagum savitus savitur vareñyam bhargah vareñyam bhargo bhargo vareñyam vareñyam bhargo devasya devasya bhargo vareñyam vareñyam bhargo devasya bhargo devasya devasya bhargo bhargo devasya dhimahi dhimahi devasya bhargo bhargo devasya dhimahi devasya dhimahi dhimahi devasya devasya dhimahi dhimahi ti dhimahi dhiyo yo yo dhiyo dhiyo yo no no yo dhiyo dhiyo yo naha yo no no yo yo na prachodayat prachodayah no yo yo na prachodayat na prachodayat prachodayah no na prachodayat prachodayaditi prachodayat.